My name is Anne Edwards and I'm a plant biologist and microbiologist at the John Innes Centre in Norwich. We're standing in Ashwellthorpe Lower Wood, an ancient woodland in Norfolk. It is about 100 acres in size and about 40 to 50% of the trees in the wood are ash trees. So behind me there's a very large ash tree. It's a female. You can see the seeds hanging from its branches. And Ashwellthorpe actually got its name from the Vikings, for whom the ash tree was a sacred tree. It was a very important part of Norse mythology. We know that ash dieback is caused by a fungus and spread by spores that land on the leaves in the summer. It kills the leaves very rapidly and they fall on the ground, and the fungus continues its growth through the branches, just growing throughout all the vascular tissue, strangling the tree. And the fungus also carries on living on the fallen leaves and produces then tiny mushrooms that are ready the following summer, and these release millions of spores to infect other ash trees. This is a healthy ash branch. You can see the smooth grey bark. In this instance, the fungus, it's killed all this wood here, and this is the leading edge of the fungus just here, which is going black. The fungus pathogen is called Hymenoscyphus fraxineus, and it's come from Asia, where it lives quite harmlessly on the Asian ash tree. When it was brought to Europe, it couldn't find its normal host, so it colonised the closest thing, which was the European ash, and for some reason it has had this devastating effect. It's far too invasive for our European ash. So this is a coppiced ash, and although the limbs are probably about 12 years old, the base, what we call the stool, is more like well over 100 years old. And this tree is completely dead. It died very, very quickly. It got infected in 2012. 3 years later, it was completely dead. The fungus has ripped through all these trunks very, very quickly. But other trees in the wood haven't reacted like this. Some are clearly infected, but they haven't died. And there seems to be a whole spectrum of tolerance to the fungus in the trees in this wood. This tree here, the limbs are the same age as the one we've just seen, but it's much more healthy. It's very close to the one that has died, so it's very likely that it's seen the fungus, it's been challenged by the fungus, but it hasn't reacted in the same way. Its trunks are very healthy, apart from a few deer nibblings here, and we're very interested to find out why that should be so. So when we knew there was a problem here in the wood in 2012, I took a small sample of infected wood back to the laboratory at John Innes and confirmed that we had this ash dieback outbreak, at which point I asked for help from my colleagues at John Innes, but also in the Sainsbury lab and the Genome Analysis Centre, and we realised that we were at the sort of centre of an epidemic that was going to sweep across the UK and that we had to do something. So it's been estimated that the UK has about 80 million ash trees, maybe 80% will die. This disease came in 2012, just 3 years ago, and since it arrived, we've learned quite a lot more about the fungus, how it lives its life, why it has such a devastating effect on the ash trees. We have to accept there are going to be changes to our landscape in the next 10 years. And we hope that we can rebuild the population of ash with a tolerant set of trees, but trees that still show genetic diversity, so they can withstand climate change and anything else that comes to challenge them.